Welcome to another commentary done by Diggity. Upper right-hand corner, we have white starting as the white Protoss. Bottom left-hand corner, we have machine starting as the gray Zerg. This is going to be on Eclipse, which between these two guys, I got to favor machine on Eclipse because it's the map that... because it just favors machine's style of play. Machine likes playing standard macro-oriented where he can just go through the motions sort of play where he doesn't have to worry about shenanigans or people doing anything crazy. He can just play heads up. And Eclipse is that map that's been in the ladder pool forever. And between the two, I think Machine has the better macro, has the better mechanics. So I'm kind of curious how this match is going to go, or why, if it was White's choice, why this map? Maybe because he just wants, could be one of those things where he's like, I just want to see how well I can do against Machine in just a straight heads up match, potentially. Pylon being dropped for, it is a forward pylon. But we'll see if we're seeing a gateway first opener, if we're going to see Forge first. I would not be shocked to see Machine go for an overpool on this map, because it is two-player. Every once in a while, he does try to pull out the 12th hatch. Yeah, there's the pool. Overpool. That does mean, I think on Eclipse, you can still pull off Nexus before... so if you go Forge, you can still get the Nexus before Cannon with the overpool. But you got to be Johnny on the spot with it, and you do need to pull probes to go ahead and defend the front. Things I've learned. The probe actually wandering around in mid-space, kind of odd. Rather than just going into the main, maybe to try to make Machine nervous. Maybe just wanting to make sure he doesn't miss the drone that's headed towards the natural expansion because he wants to get disruption there. Unfortunately, not getting the better shot there, so now he's engaging two drones, battle drones, and eating a lot of damage for basically nothing. Confirms the overpool. Probe actually wandered back with the minerals it had mined towards the front, and actually now is an opportunity, maybe, well no, it's going to be way too late. It's going to say maybe for that drone to wander up and block the Nexus. Rather than dealing with that anything here, he's going to, looks like White just going to move up to the 9 o'clock location to try to disrupt a potential third base. It looks like it's only going to be four Zerglings dedicated here from Machine. We are seeing the Photon Cannon warp in. Gateway on the front alongside that should be a nice seal. I think there's still a run-by opportunity, but we'll see. Extractor morphing. It looks like the Zerglings and the drone just going to wander up kind of with the military escort here. Make sure that probe can't get anything accomplished. Still, yeah, it just gets wiped out. So that's going to be a quick third. But the other problem with losing that probe right there is this is a good map for 973 Hydralisk push. And with that probe gone, I would not be shocked to see Machine move into that style of play. We'll see if additional probes are able to sneak out. Overlord wandering along the corner, wants to just kind of dedicate to the main. We have some Zerglings nearby. I'm curious if Zergling speed is going to be upgraded to go ahead and continually deny the scout, but honestly, even Machine might just be able to stay on top of it and continue to deny things. Let's see. Natural expansion's up. White moving to go ahead and saturate that. No additional gateway, subnex core, etc. as of yet. But now my curiosity, it looks like we are seeing three hatch. So three hatch, potentially mutilus, potentially moving back to that four hatch style. Machine not opting to go for 973, but White in the meantime needs to prepare either way, just in case. Cybernetic score warping here in the background, and he's part of the danger is if you guess wrong, if you don't get your cannons back towards your main and natural to deal with potential mutilus, you can get ransacked that direction. Or if you don't produce enough cannons on the front, then you get overrun by 973, and he has no idea what Machine's up to here. We know, though, because that lair's finished. Machine does have a drone nearby, and I'm wondering if this drone is going to plop down a spire, if we're going to see, like, pure three-hatch Mutalisk. Zealots pushing across the front. Maybe marching to that 9 o'clock location. This is going to force additional Zerglings out from Machine. Also, with these Zealots moving, they can kind of be the passive confirmation of whether Hydralisks are being produced or not. Stargate Citadel of Adun. Confirmed from machine. He's going to go ahead and try to draw that Overlord back out. I don't know that he has sufficient Zerglings to defend as of yet. They do have speed. Marching up some nice micro. Wow. Really making short work of these Zealots. Kind of dancing them around, just backing them off momentarily, forcing the Zealots to retarget. The Zealot able to at least move up into the 9 o'clock location to get a good look at the drone count, and he is going to confirm that there's 5 drones here. A probe, actually, that was kind of a brilliant... Well, actually, no, I take it back. Confirms an additional hatchery on the front. Confirms lair. So nice job on White to at least get the confirmation here, so he knows he doesn't need to plop down additional cannons towards his front. He needs to get them defensively back in his mineral line. He's already got, looks like, the pylons there to do it. First Corsair marching across to the north. The Zergling's going to go ahead and seal in White. So nice job on White's part to go ahead and force forward. Going to get an Overlord kill out of this. Scourger out of position to go help defend. Additional hatchery as well as an evolution chamber at the 9 o'clock. And a Hydral's Den. Yeah, so we're seeing kind of that come at me, bro, Zerg being built. Now it's really important to not do this. One Corsair lost. Second Corsair in threat. Just missed. Keeping these Corsair alive is critical because with this style of play, machine actually doing a good job backing off, with this style of play, there are opportunities to build Mutalisks, which it looks like machine, upon getting that first kill, is going to opt to do. And basically use Scourge to go ahead and box out your opponent. Once you have sufficient Mutalisks, you just punch through and get damage done. And we'll see if it, four is not a large enough number to get it accomplished. The Scourge testing forward, confirming a cannon there. I think he was hoping there wasn't anything, but usually like 5 or 6 Mutalisks along with this is sufficient. Looks like some Hydralisks, however, are going to be built behind this. Zealots wandering out to the front, those Mutalisks. Well, now it's kind of decision time. So machine gonna use these Mutalisks to go ahead and soften these Zealots up. Nice move command. Attack. So White not getting anything here as well, and machine just really showing, yeah, like I was saying, as far as like the stereotypical heads up play, why he's such a strong player. Everything already boxed up here to the north. Those Zealots have been extremely softened up, so honestly they're lucky to get Zergling kills. Nice split by White to go ahead and move troops both directions, but just gonna GG there, realizing that machine is outplaying him. And he wasn't able to get any damage done, and you can't let machine do that. So that's going to go ahead. So White dropping to the loser's bracket. Machine advances to the winners. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for listening.